In the last session, we discussed about the Faraday's laws and its and experiments. So what we observed in Faraday's laws, we defined two laws. What is Faraday's first law? Whenever the flux linking with the circuit is, the magnetic flux linking with the circuit is changes, then an EMF is induced. And what is Faraday's second law? That induced EMF E is directly proportional to rate of change of flux. And the coil is having single turn, we are going to write that flux as the induced EMF is E equal to d phi by dt. If the coil is having n number of turns, it is written as E is equal to n into d phi by dt. So this is the magnitude of the induced EMF according to Faraday's law whenever a coil is placed in a magnetic field. But here we are going to take the direction of induced EMF. The direction of induced EMF is represented with the negative, and that will be explained by the Lenz law. Here, magnitude of induced EMF is given by Faraday's law, and direction of the induced EMF is given by the Lenz law. The Faraday's law is given, what is the magnitude of the induced EMF, whereas this Lenz law is given the direction of the induced EMF. So first see how we explain the Lenz law. The Lenz law is polarity of induced EMF is such that it tends to produce induced current in such direction that it opposes the change in magnetic flux that produces it. Okay. Once again, see the definition. Polarity of induced EMF, that is direction of induced EMF, is such that it tends to produce induced current, means what is the EMF produced in the coil that will develop the induced current in such direction that it opposes the change in the magnetic flux that produced it, means the current is opposed the change in the magnetic flux. So due to that reason, we are going to take the negative sign for the induced EMF. So here, from this we can understand that here the what is the generated or what is the produced that always opposes its cause. Here what is the generated or produced? Then generated or produced is nothing but induced current. This induced current is always opposes its cause. What is the cause to produce induced current? The cause for producing induced current is nothing but change in the magnetic flux. Okay, the Lenz law will given the produced current or induced current is always opposes its cause. What is the cause for that? Cause is nothing but change in the magnetic flux. Okay, so here how the current will oppose the magnetic flux, so we can easily understand with the help of this diagrams. See, in this diagram, here I consider a coil which is connected to the galvanometer. We know that the work of galvanometer is it always shows the deflection when current is flowing. And here I take the bar magnet with north and south pole. Okay. So in this, whenever I bring this magnet nearer to the coil, then the galvanometer shows deflection. So here the deflection means a current can be produced. But whenever we take that magnet nearer to this one, then the coil current means what is the current induced in this coil? The coil current will oppose this one. So by opposing that, and it does not allows to that magnet to come nearer to it. Okay. So here, that means what happened here? What is the cause to produce current in this coil? The production of current in this coil is nothing but a movement of the magnet nearer to that coil. So whenever the current produced in this coil, that current is oppose that movement and repel that magnet. So due to that, the magnet is moving away from that. Okay, so this is nothing but Lenz law. So from the what we can understand is, whenever a magnet north pole is bring nearer to the coil, then here north polarity can be formed. North polarity is formed means the current direction is, see here, so this is the north polarity. So from this, what is the direction of current is flowing? The current direction is nothing but anti-clockwise direction current can be formed. Whenever the current flowing through the conductor is, or coil is, in anti-clockwise direction, then the formed pole is nothing but north pole. Whenever the north pole is formed, it will repel that magnet. So this is called Lenz law. So what is the Lenz law? Lenz law is nothing but the induced current will oppose its cause. What is the cause here? Movement of the magnet nearer to this coil. Due to that, an EMF is induced. That EMF sets a current in this coil, but here the current direction is in anti-clockwise direction. Due to the anti-clockwise direction current, here north pole is formed. So by the formation of north pole, both are the like poles. Due to that reason, the magnet can be repelled. So here clearly understand that the produced current or induced current will oppose its cause. This is called Lenz law. Due to that reason, in the EMF equation, we are going to take the negative sign. Meaning of that one, the current produced or current induced due to that EMF is always opposed the change in the magnetic flux. See, in this case, how we can justify the Lenz law? That is, whenever south pole of the magnet is brought nearer to the coil, then here also EMF is induced. That EMF sets a induced current. Due to that current, the galvanometer shows deflection. But according to Lenz law, what happened? Whenever we bring the magnet, bar magnet nearer to this coil, that magnet will oppose. Means like pole will be formed. Here south pole is take nearer to this coil. Here also south pole can be formed. So by forming of the south pole means, what is the direction of the current? So here the direction of current clearly observe. This is in the shape of S. So direction of current is like this. What is the direction of current? This is nothing but clockwise current. Okay. Whenever north pole take nearer to the coil, a anti-clockwise current can be formed. Due to that reason, there that coil will oppose the magnet. Similarly here, south pole is bring nearer to the, or brought nearer to the coil. Here the clockwise current can be formed. Due to that, south pole can be formed. So due to this reason, both are like poles. Again, this induced current will oppose the cause is nothing but movement of the magnet. So from this explanation, we clearly understand that the Lenz law, the according to Lenz law means the produced or the induced EMF or induced current, mainly induced current, the induced current is always opposed the cause. Here what is the cause? Cause is nothing but change in the magnetic flux. Due to that reason, we are going to take the negative sign for the induced EMF. Here, what is the significance of Lenz law? Means, what is the main use of the Lenz law? This is important, one more question. What is the significance of Lenz law? The significance of Lenz law is nothing but, the Lenz law is always supports the conservation of energy, or Lenz law obeys conservation of energy. So here if the question is asked, what is the significance of Lenz law? When they are going to ask, what is the significance of Lenz law? One more question is given. You have to answer it as Lenz law always obeys the conservation of energy. What is the meaning of conservative law? We know that law of conservation. What is the law of conservation? The energy neither created nor destroyed. It can transfer from one form of energy into the other form of energy. So that is called law of conservation. Similarly, here also, Lenz's law is always obeys the law of conservation. See here, how the Lenz's law will obeys law of conservation. Here, we consider a magnet and a coil. Whenever this magnet is moving towards this coil and bring back to, means by the motion of this magnet, then a EMF is induced. Due to that EMF, a induced current can be produced. So, okay, due to that EMF, a current is flowing in the circuit. Okay, now here what happened? We are, by using the external force, we are moving the magnet nearer to the coil and bring back. Again, moving nearer to the coil, bring back. So means we are applying certain mechanical energy or mechanical force. When we are applying the mechanical energy, due to that mechanical energy, when this magnet is moving, by the motion of this magnet, flux linking with this coil can be changed. Whenever the flux linking with the coil can be changed, EMF is produced. That EMF will set an induced current here. Means what happened? Here, the motion of magnet. Here, the motion of magnet represents an energy that is mechanical energy. Here, the motion of magnet is nothing but mechanical energy. By the motion of magnet, here a current is induced. Here, current is nothing but electrical energy. So here what happened? The mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. So means, what is the mechanical energy we use to move the magnet? The total mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. So due to that, the Lenz's law is always supports the law of conservation of energy, and significance of Lenz's law is nothing but Lenz's law is always obeys the conservation of energy. In Lenz's law, which energy is converted? In Lenz's law, the mechanical energy. What is the mechanical energy here? The energy which is used to the motion of a magnet. So that mechanical energy total is converted into electrical energy. How we can observe? The electrical energy is nothing but here induced current can be formed. So like that, Lenz's law is always obeys the conservation of energy. See here, next topic is methods of producing induced EMF. See, what are the methods to produce the induced EMF? Here we know that, what is the EMF equation? According to Faraday, the EMF equation is equal to magnitude. We just take the magnitude enough. E equal to N into d phi by dt. Here, the rate of change of magnetic flux is known as the induced EMF. But you know that, how to write the magnetic flux? The magnetic flux can be written as B bar dot A bar. That is, B A cos theta. Here, the flux is varying, then EMF is induced. But for the variation of flux, it is mainly depend upon three terms. One is by variation of magnetic field. Second one is by variation of area of the conductor or coil. Next, depend upon orientation. Orientation is nothing but theta. Theta is the angle between the magnetic field and the conductor or coil. So depend upon these three terms, we are going to produce the EMF in a coil. So, what are the methods to produce induced EMF? The first one is, if we can vary the magnetic field. So, first one is by varying magnetic field. This is one method. What is the second method? By varying area of coil or conductor. Next, third method, by varying angle between B and A, that is magnetic field and area, or magnetic field and the conductor. By these three methods, we can produce the induced EMF in a coil. So mainly, the production of induced EMF is depend upon the flux. If the flux is varying, then automatically induced EMF can be produced. For the variation of that flux, what are the terms we need to vary? The applied magnetic field and area of the coil and orientation between magnetic field and area. So now in this chapter, there is an important question, that is production of induced EMF or production of the MMF, that is the EMF with the variation of area. That is the important question here. Now the next topic we are going to discuss is motional EMF. See the next topic, motional EMF, important theme or question. So here we are going to derive the EMF whenever a conductor is moving. So this is the motional EMF. So for that, here I consider a stationary magnetic field. So this is the stationary magnetic field. Here I am representing with the X, that is called into. What is the meaning of into? The meaning of into is nothing but the magnetic field is into this both direction. Okay, no? Now in this I am going to assume a rectangular trench. Here I consider a rectangular trench, and on that I place a rod. A rod is placed here. Okay, and here the length of rod can be taken as L, and here EMF is induced by moving either field or coil, we know that. So here field is stationary, I took my field is stationary, but whereas a rod can be placed here, the rod is moving on this rectangular trench. Here it is moving from one end to the other end with a distance of X. So like that I am going to consider. So whenever the rod, or it is nothing but a conductor, whenever that rod is moving in the magnetic field, we know that according to Faraday, an EMF is induced. What is that EMF? That EMF E is equal to minus d phi by dt, means that EMF is depend upon flux. So first we calculate what is the flux. That flux is equal to the formula B bar dot A bar, that is equal to B A cos theta. Here the field is nothing but B. What is the area that covered by that rod? The area covered by that rod is, it is width X and length L. Now area can be taken as L into X, and into theta is the angle between the area and field. See here, it is magnetic field is into both direction. Now the area is like that, so area vector is also in the same direction. So angle between the field and area vector, for example, my hand is certain area, this area vector is like this, normal to it. Similarly, this is the area, its area vector is into the board. So from that, angle between area vector and magnetic field can be taken as 0. So this is taken as cos 0 degrees. So finally, the magnetic flux B is equal to B into Lx. Now from that, we are going to find what is the EMF induced. E is equal to minus d phi by dt. So that is minus d by dt of what is phi b? Phi b is equal to b into L into X. And here B is a stationary magnetic field. L is length of rod is not changed. But what about X? Distance traveled by the rod is changing with respect to the time. Here rod is moving like this in the magnetic field. X value can be changed. So from that, how to write this one? E is equal to minus B into L into dx by dt. Here what is dx by dt? here this rod is moving with a certain velocity v. So what is the displacement of the rod? X. What is the time? T. So from that, how to write? The velocity is equal to dx by dt. Finally, we are going to write E is equal to minus B L into V. Finally, what is the magnitude of induced EMF in the rod? That is the motional EMF is nothing but V L V. So this is the equation for the motional EMF. Here, I consider a stationary magnetic field B. The field direction is into the board. In that magnetic field, I place a trench, and on that trench, rectangular trench, on that I place a rod. Here, rod can act as the conductor. The length of the rod is L. The distance traveled by the rod is x on this trench in magnetic field. The velocity of rod can be taken as v, where velocity of rod v is equal to dx by dt. Okay. Now, first I find what is the flux in the magnetic field. Flux is equal to b bar dot a bar b into a cos theta. Here b is equal, that is equal to b into what is the area covered by this rod is L into x. Theta is the angle between area vector and B. Both are in same direction. We can take it as 0 degrees. So flux is equal to B into L into x, where B is constant, L is constant. But whenever the rod is moving, x is the variable. So now induced EMF B equal to minus d phi B by dt. By substituting here, we are going to write E equal to minus BL into dx by dt, where dx by dt is nothing but velocity. By substituting, what is the equation for the motional EMF? E is equal to B into L into V. So this is important numerical question in this chapter. In the next session, we are going to discuss about the energy considerations in this magnetic field. Thank you.